So we checked queen c7. We will check now the move b6, which is one of the main moves for sure in this position. The setup is b6. Again, we can go rook e1. There is very funny trick for some blitz games. I mean, it's not really working, but just in case, as idea. For example, here we can play e5, knight d7. And here rook e1, and we missed the g5, for example, here, yeah? So this looks like very strong. But here, out of sudden, this move c4 can change everything. At least it will be mess on the board, because after g4, cd, ed, we have very interesting move e6. And this was brought Zakharov win against Movsisyan. He took on f3, which was already wrong. After ed and knight f3, white was simply better. Black has to take the challenge and play fe6. Then after rook e6, the position becomes very, very unclear. Only move again knight db8, which is difficult to make. Another nice reply by knight g5. Taking on e6 is very bad. So he has to pick up another move, which is very strong. h6, knight c4 is coming very spectacularly, everything hanging the knight, the rook, the another knight. Still, this he has to take. Now rook c6, knight c6, bishop c6, king f8, knight e4, bishop f5 is completely unclear mess on the board. This is just a small trick. Of course, we should play rook e1. This is our main idea. No comments on d4. We just take on e4. So on rook e1, he has to play bishop b7. This is a common move. And again, here we have a choice. We can close the position with e5, or we can go c3. Actually, both possibilities are possible, because e5 gives us the possibility of playing after knight d7 c4. This is a little bit different from the setups with c3, and this is quite interesting. This was played also by Naidich, by Chigaev. We will check mostly the lines with bishop b7 c3, the classical. Queen c7. Here again we have a choice. I think definitely we were playing, the Chebanenko school was playing here knight f1 with the idea bishop f4, which is quite a good idea. I played myself against Umansky like this. For example, my game went knight f1, along castle, bishop f4. The trick was on e5 to take on e5 and play d4. So queen d7, e5, knight e8, and after h3, h6, h4, knight c7, b4, on rook g8 I did very good move, important move g4, g5, hg, hg with clear advantage for white. This was Bologan-Umansky blend 1990. So this knight f1 is quite a good move. I remember it was quite pleasant for me. Maybe the best for them is to, after knight f1, is to take on e4 and to transpose into some normal lines, which is quite reasonable for white. Let's check on queen c7, still the main move, queen e2. And what is important here, we still did not make this move e5. This is the key idea to understand how to play against black in this setup, because if here after queen e2 they will go long castle, then we didn't play e5 yet, so we can continue the pressure with a3, and only after moves like bishop a6, which is definitely waste of time and the bishop goes away from very important diagonal, then only then we play e5, knight d7, h4, h6, and another important move, h5. It's always important to stop this pawn. Okay, if he wants to play g5 here and spoil his structure, okay, that's okay with us. I mean, it's no problem. But important that he doesn't have this g5 without any paying any price for that. For example, here bishop h3, knight f8, knight f1. Will be difficult for him to push these pawns. So that's advantage for white. That's on h6. After after queen e2, short castle a3. He can also play h6, but then before is coming. Again, we didn't play e5, so this all this kind of g5, it's not dangerous for us. And we already fast attacking here. I like this plan with a3 before in this case. Also, he can play instead of castle, he can try to play here after queen e2, a5. In this case, a4 always is good. Again, we didn't play e5, so we still have some possibilities. Only after bishop a6, e5, knight d7 is good. Again, our knight goes to b1. I don't think e5, knight d7, knight b1. Because only attempt for him to use this g5 here. But then we just take on g5, knight g5, knight d5, and simply ignoring this take on d3, we go knight a3, knight b5. Well, it looks like after queen e2, and the best for him is still to go h6. And it's also kind of waiting, preparing g5 move. I like again this a3. I like to not to play e5. I like to prepare before. Again, on a5 we will play a4. If they don't play a5, then we play b4. So it's quite easy to remember. In case of g5, we definitely counterattack in the center. That's why we kept for as long as possible the pawn on e4, not on e5. Ed5, knight d5. Now with this weakness, we can already play normal knight c4, long castle a4, a6, knight e5, knight e5, knight e5, bishop f6, a5, with advantage for white. This is a Kokarev passive game 2014. So what is our conclusion on this, the whole setup with b6, then we simply should go with our traditional rook e1, c3, queen e2, and keep the tension and check. Normally we are always ready to play e5, but we are trying to provoke him, and some positions we can prepare a3 and b4. This flexibility, for example, on a3, if he will play a5, then we will play a4 and we'll get this b5 square. So this flexibility allows us to have some positional advantage.